Welcome to episode 2 of Ask Me Anything. Today we are joined by 3 members of the CREA Board of Directors, and we're going to throw some questions at them from the CREA membership. We are joined by Jill Oudil, Cliff Stevenson, and Costa Poulopoulos. Welcome to all of you. Thanks for being with us again. So let's get started with our first question from a member. As realtors, we are more than just salespeople, we are community builders. How is CREA making sure our industry is seen in a positive light across the country? Costa, what's your answer?
Wow, Mark, that's a great question. And there's just so many parts and moving parts and how integral the realtor community is to building stronger communities across Canada. I got to tell you that it starts with the advocacy that we do on behalf of consumers, the home buyers plan, basically the how we advocate to keep the Canadian dream of home ownership alive, how instrumental that is for stronger communities, to our commercial practitioners, how we build, by bringing in doctors and finding locations and chiropractors and all the commercial components that help to build a stronger community in our communities. We're integral parts of all of that. It's a very in-depth, and we're an integral part as realtors across this country, how we sincerely and truly help to build stronger communities in every spectrum of housing, from rentals all the way through to home ownership.
Jill, maybe you can go next. How is this highlighted in communities across the country, the role that members play, the role that realtors play in their respective communities?
Realtors absolutely do play. From the realtors care to the blanket drives, everyone puts in their part. And I think the great part about social media is we all get to continuously share those good things that are done by memberships and boards across the country. It's truly fabulous. I also think that the advocacy work that we do is outstanding. And in a lot of cases, I think our membership doesn't even realize, the realtors out there, how much work the GR department does and the things that you never see that actually help us be promoted in a good light. It might be stopping something as opposed to something being out there. So it's something to keep in mind.
All right, Cliff, what are your thoughts?
I think Cross and Jill touched on the advocacy and the realtors care piece. We're going to be honest and blunt here in these sessions and speak frank with the members. I think one thing I will add to this is that I think we have an opportunity to be better at telling our story. Like, these are our stories. I'll never forget reading this story about the agent who had a listing and his client was being foreclosed upon. And he actually didn't want to list the property for the sellers and get them out of their home. And he actually crowdfunded to try and get funds for these people to stay in their homes. And it was just such a great example of how much we care about our community, how important we are in the community. And I feel like this is our industry story, and we need to get better at telling this story so the public understands how ingrained and how involved we are in our communities.
All right, great. Let's move on to question number 2. How much of my dues, a member asks, are going toward paying for realtor.ca? Cliff, we're going to start with you this time.
Yeah, well, it's an interesting number. So exactly $58 out of your $310 CREA dues goes towards the creation, maintenance, the whole bit on realtor.ca. If you really want to break that down to sort of a monthly cost for your dues, it's about $4.83. I mean, I say about, but it's actually $4.83 exactly. But I want to say this about realtor.ca, because I know this is a hot topic amongst members, and it should be. This has been created by us, funded by us. We've pushed this forward as a consumer tool to help drive business and put money in the jeans of our members. But man, realtor.ca has changed over the last few years quite a bit. And you know, the consumer focus that site has taken on it's a drastic change from even 5 years ago. So seeing what we're putting in from our membership dues to support this site, I would just encourage members to go take a look and see what the consumers are experiencing on the site themselves. I think it's important we understand what that is.
Jill, what are your thoughts on this important investment that CREA is making in the realtor.ca website?
Oh, I just think it's amazing that $483 a month, which is literally such a small amount in the big scheme of things. Technology in itself has changed so drastically, as we see. I would have said by the year, but it seems like now by the day. So it is our site. It's for the membership. It's for the realtors out there. Direct leads go directly to them. I think $483 is a bargain.
Costa, what do you think?
You know, I think Jill and Cliff nailed this. Look at the realtor.ca is our site. It's the preeminent site website consumer facing for all things real estate in Canada. We're proud owners of it as Realtor members. And look, at $483 a month, $58 a year, it's constantly evolving. We're constantly making enhancements like the Realtor's listing app, where we get real-time information on your mobile app, comes right out of realtor.ca. That's a big piece of the puzzle. That's just one example of how we keep progressing and enhancing and making realtor.ca better. And the proof is in the pudding here is, you know, when we started January of 2020, we had roughly around 30% market share. And as of September 30th, the end of September, we're up almost a 42% market share of consumers. Look at all those eyeballs in the market share that has increased going to realtor.ca. And for the small amount that is allocated from our membership annual dues to that product, to capture all of those leads and to give them right back to realtors at no extra cost to realtors paying for leads, I mean, where are you going to find value like that? So you know what? It's constantly improving, constantly changing. The team at CREA is doing a fantastic job, and there's better things to come, and we're going to try to make sure that the product is where it needs to be.
All right, let's move on to question number three. Here's an interesting question from a member. I have a client who isn't on the same page when it comes to physical distancing guidelines. How best should I approach this situation? Jill?
I totally understand. I do get that as well myself. I've had it with clients and it's awkward. It's totally awkward sometimes. What I do now is I make sure that when I start out with any client that I promote what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. So out here in BC, we're lucky enough, we're an essential service. And I explain to them that we are protecting them and we are out in the public because we're an essential service and we need to make sure that they stay at least 6 feet back to protect their well-being and how we are protecting the public at all times. I also guide them to tell them exactly what I'm going to do with them. And I am going to FaceTime when we can. I'm not going to take them into properties if we don't need to and utilize all the other things that are offered on the web right now, such as virtual tours.
All right, Cliff, what's your advice when it comes to protecting social distancing in this time?
Quite frankly, handle this sensitively. You know, I don't think you need to ram anything down anybody's throat. I want to pay some respect to and offer some kudos to provincial associations and local boards that have been, that just done a great job on issuing guidance for conduct during showings and how to operate during open houses, provided that they're allowed by the certain various governing bodies. We also have provincial, federal, municipal health authorities providing us with advice on how to conduct ourselves. So I think it's really easy to go back into that toolbox that we have for guidance from organized real estate and outside of it and say, like, this is what we're relying upon and this is how I operate my business. But, you know, back to Jill's point a little bit, I think managing the expectation from the outset at the very beginning can really help in this situation. And I think that kind of communication should be standard.
Costa, what's your advice?
Yeah, again, I think Cliff and Jill have just nailed that. Look, this could be a very divisive topic, and our role as practitioners and as realtors is to not polarize this anymore. Like, you know, one party doesn't believe, one party believes. Look, our role is to, and this is what the bottom line is for consumers. They either want to buy a property or they want to make sure that they sell their property. And if we're acting for our clients and our clients' best interest, we do have to abide by health agency protocols and by provincial government protocols and rules. And so we've been doing that, but it's how we communicate to our clients and customers. Look, you may not be on the same side with provincial health authorities or municipal local authorities. We get that. Look, but you have to respect that other people are, and we have to abide by these rules and regulations. And you diplomatically explain to them that we're going to make sure that we get you into the property at the right way to do it. We have technological abilities that we can do that. And there's ways to work around it. And the bottom line is, as long as you can introduce and match up two parties to get the property bought or sold, there's ways to deal with it sensitively, as Jill and Cliff both mentioned. So that's the workaround.
All right, our next question is a related question, and that is, what is CREA doing to protect agents during the pandemic? Costa, let's go back to you.
You know what, CREA is doing a lot, and that's a great question. I've said this before, you probably heard it, you probably heard on the last episode. You know, I know location is important, but during this pandemic, it's communicate, communicate, communicate. And And so CREA has taken on that role of communication as how important it is. Look, we have a real-time podcast, we have a real-time magazine, we have the CREA COVID-19 hub for information. All of these mechanisms, all of these platforms, the CREA Cafe, emails that go out weekly, are chock full of information to make sure that the realtors in our realtor community have the most up-to-date information, how to help both themselves navigate through this and consumers. So it's probably the most important aspect right now during the pandemic is to communicate with relevant information, what we've been doing on advocacy, what we've been doing with technology, and making sure that our realtors and the professionals in our realtor community get that information, repurpose it, communicate it to their clients, and be the go-to source for all things real estate navigating through this craziness.
Cliff, what would you add here in terms of protecting agents during the pandemic?
Well, I think from a physical protection perspective, we've highlighted this before, but mobilizing virtual open houses on realtor.ca in the spring as quickly as we did was a big deal. I mean, it allowed members to get inside homes and either do virtual open houses or virtual showings with their consumer and have it advertised and bring some prominence to it. So I think that the physical element, I think that was a big initiative from CREA. The piece about the advocacy is interesting. You know, we've mentioned this before publicly as well, that our members didn't fit into any of the government assistance programs when they were first launched, like none of them. They didn't apply to us in our business models. So the advocacy that CREA stepped in and took over on behalf of members to try and get those programs more tailored to our members, that was huge. I mean, that's helped an enormous segment of our membership. So I think there's a physical piece here and there's a lobbying piece here that was very important from CREA's perspective.
All right, Jill, last word to you on this one.
I'm actually on the same page with what Cliff just said. That's what I exactly had in my mind is being able to get financial support for both realtors and brokerages and have the government continuously considering our models and how we operate has been huge. And then, of course, the communication, like Costa said, I mean, realistically, the amount of work that's being done right now due to the COVID pandemic itself is on top of all of the work that the staff and teams at CREA are already responsible for doing. So I think that's important to remember too. And you can always go to the CREA hub. It's got a ton of resources to help you through it.
All right. Last question directed to you specifically, Cliff. It's an important question. Are you disappointed that you didn't get to carry Costa's luggage on the many CREA trips that were canceled this year because of the pandemic?
This is the best question so far. Thank you for asking. Listen, I've missed the member-to-member engagement piece, just like so many of our directors on our board have. But I want to say this. Costa actually wears the same clothes every day. So this isn't like that onerous a job. Like, he can literally travel for 5 days and all of his clothes fit in a small laptop bag. It's almost like a toiletries bag. So I don't know how he does it, but like I'm pretty sure he just wears the same clothes every single day. So actually not that big a deal.
Ouch.
All right, Cliff, Costa, Jill, thank you so much for joining us on this edition of Ask Me Anything. We'll see you next time. And if you have a question for us, please send it to us. We'd love to hear from you. Maybe we'll ask your question on the next edition of Ask Me Anything. Thank you for watching.